Hey guys, it's Rob Foy here from Betway, and to be honest with you, I've never been very good with the AWP, but luckily I know someone who is. And I'm being joined by Searson to show me his warm-up routine, how he practices and how he improves with the AWP. And then we're gonna do a bit of a 1v1. And if the 1v1 of the AWPs goes badly, he's gonna go to this scout, which he'll probably wreck me even harder. So Searson, are you ready to show me how you improve and how you, get good with the AWP, basically?
I will try to improve you as a player with AWP.
Please, I need some mad help, so yeah.
Yeah, let's go. So what's the map you're using?
For warm-up, I use the CSGO hub map. And I just usually start like with AK, doing some taps and stuff, and also some sprays. I do it like for... until I reach like 300 kills and stuff, then I change the mode to shuffle. And then there are like the bots are moving and stuff, and it's even harder for me to hit them.
Yeah.
So I just play with AK, also like 200 kills until I reach like 500 and stuff. And then I go for light armor, take USP to train some pistols, change the pistol and stuff. I also do like 200 kills. I would say with pistols, but only with USP. I don't go for other pistols.
Yeah, you don't need to practice the Glock, do you?
No, I don't need to. And then, yeah, I change, of course, to the AWP and just let them shuffle around. And I just like to move around, try to do flicks and turn as fast as possible and... Ooh.
And throw the AWP in the air.
Usually I don't throw it away. And yeah, that's my warm-up, and I just try to... I don't have like a limit for the kills with the AWP. I just move around and do some shots with it, and yeah, and have some fun here listening to music and yeah, and owning the bots. I usually don't play so often deathmatch as people would expect me to, but I don't like it, to be honest, to play deathmatch, because it sometimes it hits me a lot, and it's because of the spawn kills and and I get frustrated. Usually you shouldn't do that and shouldn't get frustrated while playing deathmatch, because yeah, just you have to say to yourself, yeah, you only play it because you warm up and don't play on stats and stuff.
Yeah,
but sometimes it frustrates me, and I really don't like to play deathmatch. I just play it maybe like 10 minutes a day just to move around and yeah, and just get some feeling. Warm up,
this is how you warm up with the AWP, and you do a bit of rifles as well. What is the purpose of, if when you're an AWP, what's the purpose of doing the rifles? Because you know, as often as you can, we'll get an AWP in your hands. If not, often a scout. So is the AK? Are you trying to practice your rifles, or are you just using the AK just to really warm up your arm and get that movement going and stuff?
No, I was a rifle before I was AWP, so I really like to play AK and played it a lot, and yeah, because I was a rifle, that's the reason why. And I still really like to play rifle.
Nice. And how often do you use this map? Do you, is it something like you do every single day? And do you, like, if you're doing an official on that day and you've got an actual match, do you spend more time on the map?
No, I don't. I just do it every day like this. Like I said, I just go on this map and do like. Like the kids I want to reach, and with the weapons, and yeah, then I just stop and I just try to don't too much warm up, and I'm not a guy who needs like 1 hour warm up and stuff, so I just do like 30 minutes and I'm done with it. And I think that's the most efficient way for me personally, because I think yeah, everyone is like individually prefers something different, so you have to like find your groove and what do you like the most.
Yeah, definitely. And what made you transition from like a rifler to an AWP? Because I've always been rifler, and I've always been, you know, quite good at pistols and fairly decent aim. But I always, you know, even when I'm playing face and matchmaking, like everybody, I still like to pick up the AWP because it's a lot of fun, but I'm not particularly good at it, even though, you know, I like to think I can hit a flick shot occasionally. So yeah, what transitioned you from rifling to AWPing, and when did you realize actually, yeah, I'm a pretty good AWPer, and then even sicker scout player?
Yeah, To be honest, I was also playing a lot. I was a rifle and source. I played source back then a lot, and I was also playing in the first division of Germany at that moment. And I also played a lot of ARP, but still more rifle for sure. And yeah, when I switched, it was back in 2016 or 17. I think it was 17, to be honest, because we had no good ARPers in Germany, and I said to myself, yeah, if you want to be a good team, someone needs to ARP. And yeah, I just tried it out and I liked it a lot. And yeah, because I also liked it a lot in Source. And yeah, then I just stick to it, and now I just only use the ARP or snipers because yeah, I like them a lot and I feel the most confident with it, and really comfortable with all the sniper weapons.
Yeah. What else goes into ARPing? Because obviously you've got your warm-up routine and you've got your practice routine, which is important to have a routine and stick to it and do it every day, like you said. But ARPing isn't just about being able to hit the shots. There's also a lot about angles and movement. So as I can see here, you're bunny hopping about and your movement looks you know, probably quite good compared to a lot of pros. So what do you ever like practice your movement, or do you factor that in, or is that something that you've always been good at because you played Counter-Strike a long time?
No, I don't practice my movement at all. I don't play like climbing maps or surf maps, but I can say for sure, yeah, it improves your movement. But I don't need it, I would say. I just play warm up and that's it. I don't like to play surf maps at all. I played it a lot in Source at the beginning, or at the beginning of CSGO as well. But I played quite a lot in Source, and also climbing maps a lot in Source. And yeah, just if you play a lot, then you have in automatically like your movement improves day by day.
Tell that to Pasha Biceps. I mean, yeah. I'm just kidding. And a last question before we move on to a 1v1 is, what was it actually? Yeah, it was to do with angles and peaking and positioning. Is that something you had to learn a little bit about when you were transitioning? I know you played with the AWP and stuff like that, and you probably played with quite a good few AWPers, but how did you learn like the positioning and, you know, because it, there's a lot. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of differences between rifling and AWPing.
The first thing, which I said to myself, it what kind of player do I like, or what kind of player should I be and stuff. So if I want to be like aggressive, then I should like watch some Kenny S. And if I want to be like playing on handling, then I should go for device and stuff. Or for simple also. Aggressive, he has like a good mix between aggressive and passive, punishing enemies, and also Zaivu for sure. So you need to tell to yourself what kind of player you want to be, if you want to play on handling with grenades, and or you want to be aggressive doing moves, or do you have a good mixture between aggressive and passive. And that's what I taught myself. So I watched like a lot of device demos for sure, Kenny S and Simple. And yeah, then I found like my own game style to play aggressive, to play passive, and to play on handling, and to punish enemy mistakes. And nice. I think like it's really worth it to watch demos of the players you like, or which of the players who impress you a lot. And so it's, of course, like it's a bit annoying to do it with this demo tool, but of course, like, you have to do it if you want to improve. You have to do it.
Yeah, for sure. So it's not only about having the individual skill, but it's also learning from those who are better. And one of the best ways to learn ARPing, because you know there's only one ARPer in the team, whereas like rifles, you're surrounded by four other rifles or three other riflers, so it's easy to like learn from them when you're playing the game and learn the positions and stuff like that. But with ARPing, if you're new to ARPing, it's probably, yeah, there's probably more importance to actually watch the demos and actually learn from other ARPers because there's fewer of them.
Yeah, of course. Sweet. It's like also you have to calculate the money. I do it like every round for me by myself, like to save enough money to have like the ARP next round, or to tell my teammates, okay, I give you the eagle, you save for me for the ARP and stuff. It's also, you have to also calculate like, is it worth to do a move now because it's like risky. Of course you can open the game for your team, but it's also like you can also die unlucky and again lose this gun, and which is really expensive and it's really strong in the game. You also like have to think of that, and I think you will get to that point if you watch demos and see how they play and stuff, and then you can do it.
Yeah, definitely. I think this wouldn't be a citizen video without at least one question about the scout. So do you do anything special to practice the scout, or are you just inherently
good at it? No, I don't play scout at all. And I just played in warm-up and as well, and like in when we have to join the server, I played like in the warm-up before the game, in this like 10 minutes where we have to be on the server and stuff. That's the only thing when I play scout.
And lastly, who's a better scout player, you or Chris J?
Me.
I love the confidence. Well, you've had a little bit of warm-up here, which I haven't had too much, so I think we're going to move into a 1v1.
The rules are simple. It's going to be first to 10, AWPs only. The map is AWP India. And, you know, I'll be happy if I get 5 rounds, to be honest, which I think that's very optimistic. So, Searson, when you're ready, restart the map, and we're going live.
Let's go. Have fun, mate.
Yeah, good luck. Have fun, dude. Have you got your sound on?
Yeah, I can also play without sound if you want.
Of course. No, I've got my sound on.
Okay. No,
there's no way I could jump up there and...
No, I don't think so. I think the box is too high.
Oh, nice shot. Nice shot.
Thank you.
Okay, now it's time to try hard, because I can't lose like without getting a round. That would be embarrassing. Did you jump down? I can't. No.
No. I'm still at top.
This is not going well.
Maybe we should try to play with your AWP.
My AWP is jinxed.
Yeah, I have it now. If I die, then it's for sure jinxed. Maybe not jinxed.
No jinx.
No,
no jinx. You should have killed me. You should have killed me. You missed on purpose. No, I thought you were being serious for a second. I trusted you when you said you dropped, and I was like,
"Yeah, but I dropped it. I dropped it, but."
I didn't oh, you dropped the orb. The... I yeah, yeah, yeah. dropped down, and I'm surprised I didn't hear you. Okay, I'm changing my sensitivity. What sense do you play on?
I play 1600 DPI and Zens 0.95.
I'm not gonna be able to do the maths.
You should try it, it's good.
Am I doing any damage?
No. I think like maybe 2 rounds before you hit me through the wall.
Did we say first to 20, didn't we, or something like that?
I can also maybe switch to scout if you want. Okay, I've scout now. Okay, so now it's getting a bit more serious. Maybe I should stay with AWP?
No.
Well, okay, I'm stuck behind this track now.
No, it is.
You know, now you've got the scout, I feel a little bit more confident because, like, there's not really.
And you also play with sound? Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
I turned it down a bit now.
Okay. Volume.
But no, it's okay. Okay.
Just 0.05. There we go. It's pretty low. Okay, dude, I thought you were better at the scout than this.
Yeah, but no scope.
Yeah, I'm kidding. But you can one-shot me with the scout, can't you?
Yeah, if I hit you in your boards, then I can one-shot you.
Okay. Right in the balls.
Yes.
Ooh. Right in the eyeballs that time.
Nice.
Yeah, it was actually a decent shot by me, but. No. I don't know, I missed that to be honest. You literally ran across my screen.
Yeah.
And again, like, I missed the easiest shot ever. This is embarrassing, isn't it? I can only get kills when I'm invincible. To be fair to you, that must have been a sick shot because I just jumped.
Mm-hmm,
I jumped, you headshot me.
Yeah, it was. So,
gonna go for the headshot.
Me too.
You're gonna go for the headshot. I meant to say you're gonna go for the headshot and get it. That's. Just mixed up my words.
But you saw me? No.
Yeah, I did. Oh. Where'd you go? Dude, I'm missing the easiest shots ever.
Where are you, man?
That's a good question. Where are you?
Yeah, I'm kinda at the same position where you missed the shot.
Okay. Well played.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
No, well played though. And thank you for taking the time out of your day to give me a bit of a lesson and show the community your routine and
mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure.
And give a bit of insight into what makes a good AWPer.
Yeah, for sure. I also had really fun with you playing and talking. It was really nice.
Thank you guys for watching. Follow Sirison's tips and tricks to become a better AWPer, but also in the meantime, you'll become the sickest scout player ever. Way better than Chris J. So if you like the video, subscribe and let us know if you want us to 1v1 again, and I'll do a lot more warm up this time. Thanks for watching.